So let's go right ahead with the first demo, where I'm gonna generate the jhipster app and add an entity in order to build my REST API service. So I'm here with my Visual Studio Terminal, Visual Studio Code Terminal, and I would just create a new folder, call it maybe Hello jhipster, and then dive into it. Previously, I installed jhipster. You can either do it with Homebrew or NPM. There we go. I just entered jhipster, and now I can choose which application I want to generate. And I would just stick with the monolithic application because that should be good for my demo here. I don't need to have it reactive, and I would just call it Hello jhipster. Default package name is all right for my testing. I can choose between authentication types because it will be all built for me. And we're just going to use the simple JWT token. I will use for development the H2 SQL, and for the production one, I will use the MySQL. And yeah, we also have different Spring cache opportunities, but as we just do a demo, I will stick with no cache. And then we can also apply other technologies like the open API thing or open API solution, which is gonna generate the Swagger JSON just for me. And that's awesome because then we can use the custom connector later on. I don't need anything else, so I just press no. And then jhipster will generate the whole application for me with authentication in place, database abstraction and so on. And I can also do it directly on start.jhipster.tech. So I'm doing it right now. I can connect it to my GitHub or GitLab. I will enter the application name, and here I can choose with this very exact same options. So I can choose between a monolithic or microservice opportunity, stick with the monolithic one. I can add the company or package name here. I can also choose the port name. I don't need the jhipster registry right now. Authentication in place, database in place, good. I don't need the cache abstraction for my demo here, but I can have a cache if I want to, also generate it. I will stick with Maven and then again use the API first development because then it will generate the Swagger JSON for me as well. And we will see in a bit how I can just copy paste it then later on in my Power App. For client side, we will just use Angular, but it's going to be just a small client where I can see and add and change my data. So, and then I can just generate on GitHub. But before I do that, I would just change the application name to make it more lively, and you could also access it right now or in a few seconds. So let me change the port as well. I don't want to have it all on the same port in order to run in parallel. And I can also use another testing opportunity. I could download it in zip file, or I would just generate it on GitHub. There you go. It's generated, and you can exit it with this link. Here it is. It's just generated for me. Wait. And I said I will also need an entity. And what jhipster offers me is also a JDL studio. And it has some examples, but they're a bit too complex for our simple API. So I will just cut that out and create a new product entity. Oh, look who's there. And yeah, enter some things like the title and the description and something. Yeah, what can we need as well? So let's go with description first and then the rating. And then I would also like to add an image URL. Great, I would just stick with string because that prevents us from other issues we might have, you know, with dealing with different languages. So in this entity, I can save that and I can also download it, but I could also apply this to my GitHub repository. I would just save it first of all. And then I'm gonna apply it to my GitHub repository just created a few seconds ago. So here's my GitHub, the jhipster sampler app. Now we just apply it right now. Great. So that worked. And let's see what it did. I mean, you can also see the code changes. You can check out my GitHub for that, or I would just show it right here. So I have my Visual Studio code, and here you can see my product Java. I have the title, the description, the rating, the image URL, and also the product resource, where you can see I have the API, which offers me /API/product with the get requests or get mappings for all products, or just for one product with the ID. And I can also delete it here. Great. So let's deploy this app on Azure. And it's going to be very simple for sure, because we do have a Maven plugin for that, and it's already integrated in jhipster. So what I can do, and what jhipster allows me to, is just enter jhipster Azure App Service, because I want to deploy it on Azure App Service. And now I just have to specify some things like the Azure resource group name, and you could even skip that one if you do the command which stands above the az configure one, but I didn't want it to cheat, so that's all I need to do here. There's nothing more. Yeah, so I have to specify the app service plan name, and if there is none, it will just generate it for me. And what I also did is I chose build and deploy using GitHub Actions, and that's awesome, because that way, I only need to do this once, and it will be with every new Git push on my master branch, it will be deployed automatically for me. That saves me tons, a lot of work. You know, I have the whole CI/CD pipeline in place for me without even touching DevOps or the actions by myself, because it was just done inside the POM XML, inside the Maven plugin. Yeah, and as you can see, I did it some days ago already. You can also rerun the script or the Maven plugin without any errors. That's also very good for testing purposes, or if you want to show it like I'm doing it right now. Cool. So we have deployed the Azure app, and now I can access at myhipster.azurewebsites.net under /v2apidocs, the Swagger API file. And that's the one I just need to copy and put into a JSON, and that's the one I will hand over to the front-end team or the business intelligence department or the team in order to make it very pretty for the rest of the organization. Because to be honest, I would be good with what I have here already. So as a backend developer, I'm fine with that. So I have my calls, I can also see all the products here with my /API/products request. And if I specify an ID like this, I can also see the image URLs. And if I'm interested in the picture, I can just, you know, put it there. And there it is. But yeah, as I was told so many times by my business department and also by the front end team, that's not enough for our users.